So now let's take a look at some examples where we're actually calculating with significant figures. In chemistry, you'll be calculating a lot, and significant figures are important when you show your answer. There are two types of rules we will need to use when we are calculating. There's rules for adding and subtracting, and multiplying and dividing. When you're adding and subtracting numbers, you need to make sure your answer is expressed in the lowest number of decimal places. When you're multiplying and dividing, you need to express your answer with the lowest number of significant figures. Most of the time, you're going to be using the multiplying and dividing rules, but don't forget your adding and subtracting rules and that they are different. Now, before we do some examples, it's important to talk about rounding. There's a lot of situations where you're going to have to do multiple calculations all in one step. Make sure that when you do this that you are not rounding along the way. If you do so, you're going to have your answer get more and more off from the actual answer. So when you round, perform the calculation. Determine the proper number of significant figures in the final answer. Look at the next digit past the significant digit. If the number is greater than 5, increase that last digit to 1. If the number is less than 5, keep the significant digit. Okay, knowing that, you can see here in the addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, it gives you some sample problems to look at. For example, notice in the addition and subtraction, look at the answer, unrounded, and then look at how it's rounded right before, or right below. You can see that it's reported the lowest number of decimal places. For example, with addition, this number has 2 decimal places, this number has 4. So even though this is the answer you would get when you punch it in a calculator, this is the answer that needs to be reported to 2 decimal places. Same thing as if we were subtracting. 2 decimal places, 4 decimal places. Since 2 is the lowest number, 2 decimal places is what we report to. Notice in the second example, the second decimal place was a 4. However, since the 6 was there, it's larger than 5, it would round the second decimal place up to a 5. With multiplication and division, you're looking at lowest number of significant figures altogether. So, this number has 4, this number has 6. When you multiply, you end up getting this answer, but 4 significant figures is your lowest, and therefore 331.8 is the answer with significant figures. When you multiply and divide, you're also changing the unit. So since it was a centimeter times a centimeter, that's where we get the new units of centimeters squared. Same thing with division. 4 significant figures is our lowest, and therefore our answer is in 4 significant figures. Notice the answer is reported with no unit. Why would that be? When you take a centimeter divided by a centimeter, those centimeters will cancel out. So keep in mind when you're multiplying and dividing, you need to change the units. Let's do some more practice on the next slide. All right. So let's do some practice here. Go ahead and pause the video and work out these calculations. Then you can hit play to resume. All right, let's take a look at these answers. Simply by doing the math, you can see the answers right after the equal sign. In the first one, we're adding, and so our answer needs to have the lowest decimal places, which would be 1 decimal place versus 3. And so that's why we round the number to 90.4. Notice the meters is still the unit, because when you're adding and subtracting, the unit does not change. For the second one, we are multiplying, and so it's lowest number of significant figures. This number has 3, this has 4, and therefore we were going to take our answer and have it expressed in 3 significant figures, making it 374. Since we're multiplying centimeter times a centimeter, the new units are centimeters squared. In the third one, we are dividing, and so once again, lowest sig figs. 4 sig figs versus 2, make sure our answer is in 2 sig figs. Notice in this one, since 2 sig figs was my number, I look at the third significant digit and notice that it's an 8. That's going to round it up to 24. Since it's a meter squared divided by a meter, that's going to leave my answer in meters, because it can be written like this. Meter squared is the same thing as a meter times a meter, and then divided by a meter makes those two cancel out. Finally, in the last one, we're back to subtraction, and so it's lowest number of decimal places. 1 decimal place versus 2, make sure my answer is in 1 decimal place as well. Units there would be milliliters.